Today I'm building a children's bookshelf. Let's get cutting. I need to do two lap joints on this to create a little, guide and on the front of this. So this is going to be a bookshelf sitting hanging on a wall, and then it's going to have two protective pieces on either side to keep the books from wanting to fall out, and that way it's going to be safe for a kid's room. So now my joinery is pretty much complete. I'm only going to have to add a little bit of extra support on my miter joints. I want to make them a little bit stronger, so I'm going to add some splines to them. So I normally do thicker splines, usually two passes on the table saw blade or something like that, so it's close to a quarter of an inch. But I think I want to do it with a hand tool this time, so I'm going to make just really thin splines. So with that said, I need to cut some splines, so make some thin slivers. I'm going to do that over on the miter saw behind me, and then I need to actually create the space for the splines to slide into, and I'm going to use one of my hand saws for that. I don't know which one yet, whichever one's probably handy, but yeah. Next step, keep on moving. Bit of whitewashing on my shelving that I'm making. Very simple whitewash. This isn't anything of great quality. I was thinking about running out and grabbing some stain with a white tint to it, or adding some tint to some of the stain that I have in the shop right now. But I decided to just go with what I had in the shop, so I didn't have to make another trip. And that's just some really simple hobby acrylic paint. As anyone who's watched this channel, I tend to favor milk paint on finishing off projects, but where I wanted to just do a really thin wash over this entire surface, I think just an acrylic paint that's watered down So I'm watering it down quite a bit. So this is really thin. Just adding a little bit of paint to a little bit of water, mixing that all up. And it's giving me a nice kind of, that's my stir stick. So you can kind of get an idea of how that actually works out. So this is walnut, so a little bit darker wood, but you can see the different difference in color. So yeah, once I actually have this sanded down, I'm gonna go over it with some fine sandpaper, sand it, and I think it'll bring out a little bit more of those that wood highlights, but leave some of the more of that paint in the low spots, and I think it's gonna look fine. Relatively straightforward project. I've done two of these before. We're a little bit longer, constructed out of different material. I used alder last time I built some of these, and I used different joinery as well. These I went a little bit simpler with. The last ones I did finger joints on this joint right here, but this time I just did a miter and put some splines in them. And I also did some lap joints for these crossbars. And it's kind of interesting because normally you situate books like this, but to kind of serve as a display and easier to for kids to pick out the books that they want, the books on this shelf are meant to be oriented this way. So they're going to be facing outward. That's a fun. And then you can also use this as a little extra storage shelf for like a stuffed animal or something along those lines. These are all painted with just a really simple acrylic whitewash, just a really watered down acrylic paint, and then a really quick spray polyurethane over top of everything. I try not to use the spray polyurethane that often because I know it's wasteful and you're wasting, you have these cans that go up and it's not the best way of going about it, but they cover so easily, so whenever I'm even remotely in a rush, I have a tendency to go to spray polyurethane. But the polyurethane isn't the final step on these. I'm going to put one more coat of mini wax over top of the whole thing just to lock it in and smooth it out a little bit, and that gives me a surface that I can polish up slightly, so it just has a tiny bit more sheen. I built three of them, lots of extra room. Anyone who has kids, I think, can attest that children's books seem to multiply faster than almost anything, even faster than onesies. So, yeah, I need more bookshelves. I'll keep them coming. We'll be right back.